Well, good morning. It's, what day is it? It's Thursday morning. I'm already up in Seattle. You can probably tell because it's light outside. It's 9 o'clock in the morning. I left, the yard at like 3:30, got fuel and whatnot, got up here at like 7. There was a truck in front of me, right outside the door. At this place we unload inside, so he was sitting right outside the door, which is where you untarp. So I parked behind him, and I couldn't start untarping or untying. They don't want you to start untarping or untying until you get into the spot, so sat there and wait for him to untarp. Actually, I helped him. It was nice and dry then. Finally they pulled him in, so I pulled up into the untarp spot, and then it started raining. So I just got done getting all my tarps off and getting ready to be unloaded, so I'm nice and soaking wet now. But they're rejecting one of the, it's big steel tubes. He has, I don't know, they're probably 12 inch by 12 inch or 14 inch by 14 inch. They're bigger than what I have, but they've unloaded all of them except one, and they're like rejecting that one because it's kind of bent or something. So now they're dealing with all that, which means I get to sit and wait some more. But yeah, whatever, at least I'm not out in the rain now. So yeah, that's how my morning's going so far. Just kind of sitting here watching. The front of my truck's right at the door, so they're, I don't know, 50 feet in front of me or something, watching them try to figure out what to do. They're taking pictures and trying to sort out what to do, because they don't want to take the bent beam thing, and it had to have been damaged when they loaded him. So the shipper basically damaged it and sent it up here damaged. They don't want to receive it damaged, so they don't want to take it off the truck. Well, being a driver, he picked that up in California. You know, it's not his responsibility at this point to take that all the way back to California. Like, really what should happen, and if I was in that position, I would call dispatch, and they would sort it all out. They would basically tell them, you need to unload that off my driver's truck because he has somewhere else he needs to be, and schedule the truck that's going that way to come pick it up or something like that. That, you know, it wouldn't just stay on his truck. I'm assuming that's what that driver's trying to sort out, so that's what's taking a while, but I don't know. Anyhow, more hurry up and wait, kind of a continuation of yesterday. Maybe it's this load. Funny thing is, the pickup number at the shipper yesterday, the pickup number was 27666. And when I first checked in, the guy was like, oh, that's a bad load. And I was like, oh, no, it'll be fine. It's good. He was like, no, that's unlucky. And I was like, well, it's only what you make of it, right? It's going to be a great load. And I've had a lot of waiting, a lot of getting wet, both tarping and untarping. And it's still fine. I mean, it's, you know, it's part of living up here in the Northwest. If you don't like the rain, you shouldn't live here, because you're going to get wet. So, anyways, I'm going to hurry up and wait, and check back in a while. Well, today's shaping up to be a long day. It was already going to be a long day, because it's my go north day, but it's 10:15. I'm inside now. He's taken two picks off of me, which it takes him probably 10 minutes to take one off, right? He lifts it up with the crane, and then they run, it's an overhead crane, run it all the way down to the other end of the building, slowly, set it down, unhook the things on both ends, whatever, and then come back. So it takes like 10 minutes for one pick. He's taken like two picks off, and those two picks were half of a pick at the place that loaded me. They have the same cranes here, the same weight rating and everything. I was looking at them. Basically, the guy loading me was lifting 8 of the big square tubing things per pick. And this guy's taking 2. So I've got 28 total pieces. if he's taking two per pick at 10 minutes apiece, I mean, that's, you know, a couple hours to unload me. I've already been here for 3 hours. Already been working, you know, 7 hours or something. And at the rate things are going, I'm going to be here another hour and a half. And then I've still got to go somewhere else, get loaded to go back south, and then drive all the way back south. So, anyways. It's fine. I'm just bored. I think I'm going to make myself something to eat, because I've got time. It takes, I don't know, I've got, I think maybe I showed you in one of the past videos, but I've got a thing to boil water. It takes like 20 minutes or something to boil it. But I'm certain I've got that much time, so I'm gonna do it. You ready for it? All right. Oops. Bonked my head. Good thing that's soft. All right. So I finally got out of that place I was at and made it down to Auburn. I don't know, it's like 30-ish miles away. To where I'm picking up. So I don't know if I've told you guys. I used to drive for this company that I'm leased to now 6 or 7 years ago. And then obviously I've been gone for 6 or 7 years. Sorry, I'm working on making myself some noodles. I never made some noodles earlier. I ended up having some peaches. So I gotta sit you down for a second. You can look at my belly or my chest or whatever it's pointed at. Okay. So anyways, I worked here 6 or 7 years ago. So, and I just recently came back about a month ago. So I've been to a lot of these customers before, but it's been a long time. So this was one where as soon as dispatch told me where I was going, I knew I'd been here before. I remembered where it was and everything. So I was like, cool, I know where I'm going. I thought one thing was interesting. Oops, sorry. She just told me how much deck space it was gonna take on my trailer and whatnot. Which I remember when we came here before, what we would do, they would already have trailers. They had a bunch of our trailers here out in the street preloaded. So we would basically pull up, find an empty spot, drop our trailer that we have in the street, hook up to one that's already loaded, tie it down, grab our paperwork from the office, and go. But when she dispatched me on this, she didn't give me a trailer number to pick up or anything, so it's like, all right, so something's at least changed. They must live load now. But whatever, so I headed this way. My GPS was telling me some weird way to get here, that I remembered how to get here. I knew which exit to take, and when I got to that exit, it was telling me to keep going on the highway, and then I was still like 6 miles away, and I was like, no, it's like a half a mile off this exit. So, whatever. I took the exit, turned left off the exit, which is what I needed to do, and then all of a sudden, like, a warning pops up on my GPS telling me there's, like, a weight restriction, and then there's a sign saying no vehicles over 15 tons. Which is great, because empty, I'm 200 pounds under 15 tons or something, so yeah, I can sneak by just barely, since I'm empty. But I don't remember that being a restriction before. Maybe it was. Maybe I just ignored it. I don't know. Well, although I don't remember that leaving. I don't remember if I left that way. So maybe I just came that way before when I was empty because I knew I was under the restriction, and then we'll see what my GPS tells me when it's time to leave, how to get out of here. Anyways, so I get here, and I see it's the road it's on is a cul-de-sac. And the road's lined with semis parked. None of them are flatbeds, and none of them are preloaded trailers, so obviously something's different. So I got down here and I parked. It wasn't obvious where to go. They had no signs. A lot of places will have signs saying, like, truck entrance or something, and there was nothing. So I could see, you know, I remembered where the place was at, but I've never been loaded here. I always picked up an already loaded trailer. So I parked in the street and came in and asked. And they told me they were going to have me back into this bay, basically, which is where I'm backed into now. The thing about it is, let me go up here. Oh. So, let's see. So I had to go in one entrance and come around the building. So you can basically see out my window. That's where I came from. And I pulled around here. Yep.
No problem.
Okay. So, anyways. So I pulled around here, and you can see there's not really any room here. So I nosed up by that forklift over there. And, had to jackknife it like crazy to get backed in here to this bay that I'm in. They must be pretty used to it with their yard goats or whatever, getting, although the trucks I've seen in here since I was here parked, they were all straight trucks. They were all, you know, class B little trucks. They've got some semi-trailers here, and they're loaded. But they look like they're mostly 40-foot trailers, and I've got a 48-foot. Also, the trailers that are here are tandems, which turn a lot sharper, especially with the tandem slidway forward. And I've got a spread axle, which turns a lot slower. Anyways, none of it's that big of a deal, other than it was very tight. It was, yeah. So, I'm in here now. I got checked in and got backed in, and they were like, alright, well, we're going to go to lunch, so it's going to be like 45 minutes. So, yeah, crap, of course. So, I've got me some water boiling, as I guess I was talking to you when I got that going. And then, as you just heard, I'm assuming you heard, he just came and I left the paperwork sitting on the step of my truck so that he wouldn't have to knock and interrupt me. The load list for what they're going to put on me. And he didn't even see it there, so he just came and knocked on the door and asked for the load list, and I just pointed down at the step, and he was like, oh, I didn't even see it there. So, in case you didn't hear that, that's what happened. So, sounds like they're going to go ahead and get started loading me, even though the boss is going to lunch. So, hopefully I'll be out of here soon. Anyways, I just figured I'd take a minute to show you how little room I guess I had. And some of you guys might be like, oh, I don't know, that's a ton of room. Mm-mm. Like I said, I can see it being a ton of room if you've got tandem slid all the way forward, but I was, there's a flatbed right there, going sideways in front of me, right? I needed the front of my truck to be able to swing over, but that trailer was there, which was one thing to make it pretty tight. Also, as I was trying to jackknife it to swing the front of the trailer over, the back of my truck was getting close to the front of that trailer. So it would have been, there would have been more room if that trailer wasn't there. And it would have been a lot better if that all those coils weren't there and that forklift over there, because it would have let me pull up just, if I could have pulled up another 4 feet over there or something like that, I wouldn't have had to, like, pretty much jackknife it so much. But, just coming around this building from over there, obviously the goal is, I don't know if you can see my hand, I want to get the trailer over here and pivoted so that the back is almost pointed in the door already. But without being able, if the door was right here, obviously if I could, let me switch hands. If I could swing the trailer around and get the trailer right here, then it's easy to just back it right in. What ended up happening was the opening is here, but the back of my trailer was like here, where if I could have just pulled forward just a hair more, it would have been an easy, I don't know if you could have even seen that. I don't know where the camera was pointed. I was paying more attention to my hand, but anyways, Any of you that drive truck, I'm sure, know what I mean. Any of you that don't, yeah, whatever. I don't know if you do or not, but I was a bit nervous for it because also inside the bay door, it's, you know, 9 feet wide. The actual door is 20 feet wide, but there's all kinds of crap piled around it, and so the spot to get in was very tight, so there wasn't any really wiggle room. But... well, I'm on my way home, or on my way back to the yard. Nothing really exciting has happened. There's not a whole lot to talk about today. I've just been hurrying it up and waiting. I just stopped at a truck stop a bit ago. Bought an airline for the back to connect a trailer. There's a red line and a blue line. Looks like my blue line has a bit of a kink in it, so I bought a new one. So I'll bring some tools with me tomorrow. That's one of the things I'm realizing I don't have in the truck. It's tools. So I'll have to start getting some tools in here, but I'll bring some tomorrow, and then while they're unloading me at my delivery, crap in the road, clothes or something. I'll see if I can swap out that airline real quick. I bought a fancy schmancy tire pressure gauge for a semi, and I bought a coax cable for my CB, dual coax, and brackets to mount antennas. I didn't buy antennas though, for a couple reasons. One, there's antennas on the truck in a different location, in the stock location, which when I first hook it all up, I can just take those antennas, move them to the new brackets I just bought to test it. And then if that works, I'll buy some fancy antennas, because that's how I roll. I can't just have normal stuff. So yeah, I think my daughter has school parent-teacher conferences tonight, so gonna be getting home awful late compared to normal because of all the waiting I had to do today. That got me thinking, actually, that's kind of why I started recording again, about when I was picking up that load of steel yesterday, and I told you earlier the guy, the pickup number was 27666, and the guy was talking about how unlucky or bad of a load or whatever that was going to be, and man, that load did seem to mess with me, which, like I told him yesterday, it's going to be whatever kind of load you believe it's going to be, right? Well, maybe subconsciously I did believe that there was going to be a bunch of headache with it, because there sure was. I guess not really a bunch of headache, but a bunch of delays, a bunch of road spray. Because, so as soon as I got that load, it was raining, had to tarp in the rain, got soaked, that wasn't fun. When I got up there to deliver, it was fine, the ground wasn't dry, but it wasn't raining. And I helped the guy in front of me take his tarps off and all that, and it was fine. As soon as I started untarping, it started pouring. As soon as I got done untarping, it stopped pouring. It was still raining a bit for maybe another half hour, and then it kind of quit raining. Still gray and gloomy. Once my paperwork got signed and I left that to go to my next job, it was sunny. I'm in a t-shirt. As soon as I was done with that job, the sun came out. So my next pickup, where I picked up the rebar that I have on now, beautiful. It was still wet. You could tell it had rained there in the morning, but it was warm and comfortable in a t-shirt. And now heading south, I keep hitting, there's patches. Like right now, I got the wipers on and because of road spray. It's not raining, but the road's really wet and all the traffic, there's a semi, a flatbed in front of me that's stirring up a lot of water and all the cars going by are making a watery mess that's, you know, making me need my wipers, but it's sunny. I might have talked about, well, I don't know if I left it in or not, but the other day I said something about, I think I edited it out. I imagine this being one of the few places where it can be blue sky and sunny and raining at the same time. But there's a big patch of blue sky over there. The ground's soaking wet, the wipers are on. I don't know. You can probably see out that way. I see blue sky. It's blue right up there. I don't know what it's like kind of from what you can probably see. There's a lot of blue sky around me. So, anyhow, maybe that was a cursed load. But we've moved on to our next load. And yeah, tomorrow will be another step in getting my truck more, I guess, prepared. I don't know. I'll bring some tools. I might have to go through my son's toolbox. I have a lot of tools. And I don't know, a year ago or maybe even 2 years ago at this point, my son was always wanting to use my tools. And so I was like, well, let's go through my toolbox and get you some tools. And I've got a big roll around Craftsman box that's, you know, chest high or whatever. And it was just overflowing with hand tools, you know, screwdrivers and wrenches, sockets, ratchets, all the normal hand tools, all sorts of pliers and channel locks and just all that stuff. So I basically went through all of it. Everything that was Craftsman, I left in the big box. Everything that wasn't, I gave to my son. There was actually, why are we going so slow? I just realized how slow we're going. There was actually a fair amount of tools. I gave him a toolbox, not a big roll around or anything, but a decent size, you know. It's a metal, like, carry around. I don't know who would carry it around. I mean, with tools in it, things hard to lift. But it's stacked full, like, not organized, just stacked full. So there's just way more stuff than he would need. So I'll probably go through that and grab some crescent wrenches and some end wrenches and just a few things that would be handy to have in the truck, and bring some of that stuff tomorrow so that I can, one, do that hose, and then if I get that hose replaced and they're still not done unloading me, maybe I'll climb underneath and adjust the brakes, which reminds me, I have a couple tire chocks at home, semi-truck tire chocks, that I could probably bring too. The thing about this Cascadia is it doesn't have, like, hardly any storage. It has storage inside, which is great, but it doesn't have, like, the last truck I pulled flatbeds with was a Peterbilt, and it had doors on both sides of the truck to access, you know, storage compartments under the bunk and all that. This only has a door on one side, and I think the Pete, I know the car hauler, it was a Pete also, when I was driving a car hauler, it had a door on each side, and then along the very back of it was like a tunnel that went all the way through that connected the sides so you could put long stuff in there. This just has one tiny box on this side and that's it. Then there's a Protec box outside, but both of those are full. So, like, tire chocks are going to have to go under my bunk. And, tools. I'll have to put a tool bag or a toolbox under my bunk. I'm going to have to go inside the truck because I don't have anywhere else to put it. So, anyhow, this is my day now. It's 3:30. So, I started work this morning at 3:30. I think it was 3:30. So, I'm 12 hours into my day. I'll be back to the yard in about an hour. I'm, 62 miles away. So, I'll be pretty darn close to exactly an hour. Because it's all freeway from here to there. Basically, once I get off the highway, it's a half a mile from the yard. So I'm almost home. So I probably won't record anymore after this. I might even edit this.